they targeted and they shoot his leg. Moment he got a bullet, he fell down. Then I took the rocket launcher and I fired. So with that impact, almost 2 people are died, those militants. Myself, Major Raghuram Reddy. I am from Bangalore, Anekal Taluk. So I served for the country for 24 years. So during my service, most of the time I was in Jammu and Kashmir and northern part of India. And I represented to United Nations peacekeeping force in African countries. Yeah, in my entire family, my uncle was there. He was also again major, retired. So I got a motivation from my uncle to joining army. Yeah, borders very difficult to survive there. Like if you go to Kargil, you find minus 30, 35, sometimes it goes to 42 degrees Celsius. So there is a place called Dross, close to Kargil, where that war was fought in 1999. That was Tiger Hill. That is close to the Kargil and Dross sector. So Dross is the place where people used to train there. Those who are coming for forward areas, they used to train there. And staying in those border areas, and close contact with the enemies, Pakistani army. So though it looks very adventurous, but its life is very uncertain. So it was a very challenging task was given to me. So I'm supposed to travel for 60 kilometers and with the troops. So I was leading the team, about 45 people. So there was a track existing, there was no road connections. So while traveling with a team of 35 members, so I found there was an ambush where militants are sitting there. They want to kill us. I got a doubt, so something is wrong. So I have to take some necessary steps before I am moving ahead. So they're just waiting for us to come close by, coming to that firing range. They want to kill us. So moment I went, I was the person who was leading guide with my buddies. So the buddy who was walking behind me, he was carrying a rocket launcher. If they kill him, then I can't do anything, because though I have weapons, AK-47 weapon, they targeted and they shoot his leg. Moment he got a bullet, he fell down. Then I took the rocket launcher and I fired. So with that impact, almost 2 people have died, those militants. I suspected around 6 militants were there. So the person who was taken the bullet, who is there next to me, because to save me, being a commander of that party, he took the bullet, 3 bullets on his chest. And unluckily, that day, there was no choppers, means helicopters, because of the bad weather. So I have to travel around 15 kilometers back to my camp, base camp. So with the support from my soldiers were there. Then I carry him in my shoulders around 15 kilometers. Then luckily we took him to hospital, nearest hospital, and he survived. If you support your troops, if you help your troops, if you take care of your troops, the troops will always take care of you. It's really very sad, you know, people thinking that, okay, some people say, okay, soldiers are serving for the sake of their part of a life. But some matured people, those who understand what is nation, what is army, they'll always think in a positive way. But it has to come from their heart, you know. Everyone should understand why today we are independent. What is the reason behind this? Those who are sitting there on the border, they're guarding the nation. Those who are common men sitting in cities and towns, they should also understand what is the impact on those people who are sitting there. So we are safe here because of our soldiers sitting there on the borders. First of all, congratulations to everyone for the Independence Day. So respect soldiers, respect Indian Armed Forces. Thank you so much, and it is my pleasure to interacting with you, sharing my views. So really, I am honored. Thank you. Have a nice day.